Hey YouTube, my name is Dan and this is a short free extract of my longer course called Animated Infographics and Data Visualization. That course, along with the free exercise files for this particular video and a free downloadable cheat sheet, can be found at bringyourownlaptop.com. Right. In this tutorial, we're going to look at anticipation. It's when things go up before they go down, or left before they go right, or they get big before they get smaller. We're going to learn that, and we're going to learn how to use this graph editor down the bottom here. All right, let's go and do it with this type. Okay, to make it work, what we need to do at the moment, we've got the beginning, it starts playing, fades in, and it's running a little bit slow. So I was going to save this for a tutorial later on, but my machine is having a bad day. It's trying to record the screen for you and do this HD animation at the same time. So what I'm going to have to do is see where it says full. Yours might be set to auto, so it's in brackets. What we're going to do is set it to a quarter. So it just means the resolution in preview is going to be a bit little. You can see it's gone a little bit pixelated there. So that versus full. Okay, it doesn't actually change your output. It just means previewing within After Effects is a little nicer. Okay, so I'm gonna zoom out so I can see the edges. Now, what I wanna do is, remember down here, it was with this type. Remember U shows me the keyframes. Now, I've got these first keyframe where it fades in. I'm gonna keep that. It's these last two keyframes I don't want. I'm gonna get it to transition out with a jump. This is gonna stay for a while. Now, what I wanna do is I want to put in a position. So we're gonna open up position. Now, a cool little shortcut is I can just tap P on my keyboard. And what it means is instead of having to open all of this up and find position, I just tap P on my keyboard. So it's the first letter. S is for scale, R is for rotation, and it just saves you time jumping around trying to twirl these down and figure them all out. Plus it's a lot tidier. The only one thing that's a bit weird is you don't use O, okay, for opacity, use T for transparency. O does something really weird. Okay, if you do hit O and it ends up way out here, it just means your playhead has ended up past the screen. With no man's land, you have to kind of like drag it back. Come on. Don't click O. You will though. All right, so where were we? About there, about 3 seconds in, I wanted to get it to jump down. So remember P for position. And we want to set a keyframe. Then a little bit later, it's hard to know beforehand how far to keep these apart to make this look real. We have to really play with them afterwards. It's because it really depends on the size of the object you're moving and how much you move it and how fast you move it. Okay, so what we want to do is we've got our first keyframe there. Our second keyframe, I want it to go up a little bit. Not that way. I want it to go up a little bit. Okay, how get it to go up high enough. I find if you do it too low, it becomes really hard to work with. How high is that? Too high. Okay, there is a limit to the height. Okay, so it's going to go up a bit, and then after a little chunk, it's going to go completely down. So I'm going to move it down to the bottom here. So it starts up, starts down. You saw I used position instead of dragging it. It's just easier. I often use the position slider. Now, by default, it looks pretty crappy. Okay, so what we want to do is we want to add some easing. Now, if I right-click all of these guys, and we're going to use easy ease in this case just because, what happens? It's not great. Okay, so we're going to have to get into using something called the graph editor. Up until now, and pretty much after this, you get away with just using velocity and picking influence or using easy ease. But now we're going to have to use the graph editor. And if you find it a little bit tough, it kind of is for new people. And if I was truly honest with you, I find it a little bit tough as well. So to switch to the graph editor, okay, it's this little icon here. I've got these icons selected first. Okay, so I selected these keyframes, click on graph editor, and that's what's happening. That's why it's kind of looking a bit weird. No, there is a... Does a kind of like a weird little jump, there doesn't is... quite work. It's because this flow is not very nice. At the moment though, the X and Y coordinates are stitched together and you can't adjust these little handles. Okay, so what we have to do is we need to break them apart. There's this little X and Y. You'll notice when you break it apart, it actually changes. Oh man, it's one of the quirks for it. Now, what we want to do to make this thing look nice is we want, so this is our two keyframes. That's when it's, see my playhead? That's when it's normal, that's when it's up high, and that's when it's down low. So what we want to do is it looks really good if this is a nice, smooth kind of line at the top here. Okay, and these ones here, I'm going to kind of adjust. Okay, you're going to have to play around with them, but this one here is going to come up a little bit. This nice bend often looks good. Let's give it a go. Cool. So it's got the right kind of rhythm, it's just maybe not fast enough. So we're going to jump back from the graph editor. Okay, you'll notice that it split them when we did that in the graph editor. We say separate the X and Y. So now we've got two of them to deal with. We don't really need X or Y. Oh, which is the up and down one? I can never remember. I'm going to leave them both there because, oh man. But anyway, so what we're going to do is we're going to play around with the timing. So I might just grab this, tighten this one up, grab this one, tighten it up. Okay, just so it happens a bit faster. No, there isn't. Okay, maybe not quite enough. Okay, so it's working. It's definitely looking. I'm gonna turn the mute on these two. They're driving me bananas. So it's getting there, right? Switch back to the graph editor just to make sure that you haven't wrecked it in here. Switch back, okay, and start playing around with this. And you can kind of start to see, yep. Okay, I might go a little higher. So I'm gonna get to here and I'm gonna have to work out if it's X or Y. It's Y the whole time. Okay, so I don't need X. You can just bin X. Okay, just clean it up. Okay, now I'm gonna go, yep. Oh, I've kind of wrecked it even more. So it's going higher, then it's faster. I'm going to speed that in there. So you end up duplicating a lot with this to see if you can make it work. Now, before you leave, I have to make it look nice. It's getting there. Okay, let's have a look at the graph editor just to make sure before we go. We haven't wrecked it. There, I think that feels good. And when I said before it needs to be this perfect curve, actually it'll look nicer with a little double bend here. So bending kind of out and up. So it kind of starts slow, goes fast in the middle, gets slow again, and goes fast at the end. I like to save that last little tidbit for the end to make sure you're still watching. Okay, I'm gonna speed it out a little bit. It's been ages kind of making this look great. I'm happy with that. Now to make it look even nicer is to turn the motion blur on. Okay, make sure it's on for the actual project as well as the layer. Okay, let's give it a little go. Looks nicer when it's moving, can you see? I don't know why I add my own sound effects, but I'll do that throughout this course. All right, it took a little while, but there's a lot of finesse when it comes to getting things to feel the right kind of feeling when, you know, the right kind of weight when it's moving. Okay, it's called anticipation, and it makes inanimate objects look a little more real. Let's get on to the next animation tip. Hey there, what'd you think? If you liked the video, hit the like button, that'd be great. Also consider subscribing to my channel. Now, this is a free part of a longer course. You can check that out on bringyourownlaptop.com. On that site is a free downloadable, printable PDF cheat sheet, okay, to help you with your infographics and data visualization. Also on that site is a bunch of other courses as well. So go check it out, bringyourownlaptop.com. Bye now.